you're so UBA, why did you want to join the UBA? What was the drive for you to sit there and come out there and start in UBA day one? Not now.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on now that it wasn't going on back then.
Yeah.
Back then, there was a lot more popping going on.
Oh, yeah,
there
yeah,
was
yeah,
a lot
yeah,
more
yeah.
talking. There was a lot more videos. Yeah. There's a lot more ish. So now it's a little bit more, I don't want to say stereotypical, but it's more it's more like family friendly. It's a little more laid back.
It's not even
family
friendly. Like, we've been doing this for a while, right?
Yep.
I started year three. You started probably year four, maybe, at the most. Year four. So we've been doing this for a long time. I won't say it's old to us, but we've been doing it for a while. So it seems second nature. It seems a little bit more quiet because we've just gotten used to it. And we're getting older, so it's not as hype anymore.
Our division
our division doesn't dictate that. You know what I mean? They don't have a lot of personalities that drive some of the trash talking, some of the back and forth. We don't have a lot of personalities that drive that.
Right.
We have a lot of great bowlers that let their bowling do the talking for them.
You have a personality, you just don't have, they don't trash talk.
Right.
I say personality, that means talent. That means talent, right?
Yeah.
But back when I got in, I mean, we got in this for, it was nice to see something about bowling that franchised people around a team atmosphere that allowed you to act like you were at a football stadium, right? You know what I mean? You could get involved. You could be rowdy. It was like being at a football stadium, but for bowling. You know what I mean? You saw the PBA and you saw it was really quiet, really, really laid back, really reserved. With us,
scripted.
Yeah, scripted. With us, it was real freestyle. You got what you saw. People would just go off the cuff and let you have it. You know what I mean? So when we started, it was a real, real raucous atmosphere. And that's what people liked. Now, because we've been doing it so long, we don't get that raucous atmosphere no more. You know what I mean?
Because
see the young boys come up and do that joint.
Right. Well, now, for me, like you said, we came in from beginning and day one-ish and blah, 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 blah. But for me, I knew that it was a travel league. I knew that we were going to be doing traveling. But once you sit there and say, hey, listen, we have enough teams in said division, now you have division, I miss not bowling the Northern bowlers. I miss not bowling the PA bowlers. Like, once you sit there and, like, I bowl with you bowl guys on league bowl. I don't want to see you guys on the weekend. That's why I want to sit there and venture out to other tournaments and sit there and want to go do, like, the mixer next weekend. I'm driving to Maryland just so I can get away from people, only to sit there and bowl with North Jersey people that I can possibly be bowling with in a inner conference or a, hey guys, like, every week we're going to sit there and do something different. Like I knew signing up that we're travel league. Like, before I started, I was bowling at Baker Lanes.
Yeah.
And Cheryl Mitchell walked in with a New York Bombers shirt. She was driving to New York.
Yeah.
Every other weekend, yep, just to sit there and bowl in the UBA.
Yeah, man.
Until it got down to us.
Yep.
So we all knew that it was a travel aspect. We lost the drive. Theoretically.
Nobody wants to drive no more.
Nobody wants to drive no more.
We know all about
that. Driving? Yeah. Well, no, you brought up a great point about the travel aspect. When we first started with the smaller amount of teams, Jersey went to New York, New York went to Jersey, and some of my favorite moments were going to Jib Lanes, was going out to, Whitestone, you know what I mean? Those were some fun moments, and I missed, in all honesty, I miss it now, being able to participate. And, you know, it's not because I can't go out there, simply because sometimes your family life doesn't allow you to do the things that you used to do, but the travel aspect that you brought up was a big part of the original UBA aspect. And you start, when you say I'm so UBA, you're saying I'm so UBA. I remember when Ed Lover was on TV. I remember when Ed Lover was on the lane.
Bruh.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
I remember, I'm so UBA. I remember my king of the UBA
was Derrick Brown Sr. Best believe. I'm so UBA, that's how we did it, you know what I mean?
You know what I mean? I know you got one more in you.
Gosh.
You got Ed Lover. You already dropped Ed Lover. Like, I mean, I'm so UBA that we retired the Long Island Rounders.
That one, yeah. They out there burning uniforms and stuff. You know what I mean? It's real. We've been doing this for a long time. And I'm so UBA that my club is now the oldest active club in Jersey. Shooters are retired. Good Brothers retired. Syndicate is the next oldest ones. We, you know what I mean? That's our
final 13. Yeah. You was the lead 13 coming into the.
Yeah,
into
that's, the, we're the oldest active Jersey club. So a lot of the history and when everybody says, yo, why you doing what you're doing, is because I don't want to lose out on that history, you know what I mean?
Yeah.